Hello, my friend. I'm back officially. And how are you? In today's video, I want to share with you the biggest lesson that I learned from last year. What is the thing that holding us back from doing what really matters? Today's video is going to be a coffee chat. I'm not going to put any insert in the video, and you can totally put me in the background while you're doing chores. It's like friend chat with friends, and I know you guys have been waiting for coffee chat for a while, and here we go. And before I start, I want to give you an update on what's going on with me and the changes that I have made. Be patient with me. This has a lot to do with today's topic. The change I made earlier this year is that I stepped down from my day job, meaning I stepped down from my position, and now I'm only work part-time. I get paid less. I only make half of what I used to make. This is a big change for me, and it's quite scary because now my financial situation will become more and more unstable. But I'm going to share with you why I decide to do that a little bit later. Before I talk about that, I want to share a concept with you, and then this concept will help you understand what's the thing that holding us back from doing what matters. I've been reading a book called 12 Week Years, and I learned this concept through the book. This concept is called productive tension. Productive tension is the uncomfortable feeling you get when you're not doing the things you know you need to do. If you click into this video, you know exactly what the productive tension means. You know the feeling. It's the kind of nagging feeling that you have when you are not doing what you know it matters to you. And then you feel it in the stomach, and then you feel very negative, and sometimes it kind of put you into a downward spiral, and then you just keep feeling worse and worse and eventually burned out from that feeling. So what is the thing we do when we face productive tension? As a human being, naturally, when we have any uncomfortable feelings, we tend to use our tactic, avoidance, to help us distract from the feeling. No matter it's sadness, anger, or depression, we tend to avoid by changing the subject or by distracting ourselves by doing other things. That's one thing we like to do when we experience productive tension. We start occupying ourselves with things that doesn't matter. And then we're looking for excuse to justify why we need to do those unimportant things. We are lacking of results of the things that truly matters because we've been distracting ourselves by keeping ourselves busy. That's what happened to me last year. I don't know if you remember, at the beginning of last year, I decided to take on a second promotion at my day job. Part of me took that part because I feel since I'm already at the day job working same amount of hour, I might as well getting paid more. Another part of it is because to be in a management position, it kind of boosts my ego. Something my parents always wanted me to do is to always thrive in any given situation, to be the good one, the best one. So at any given environment, including my day job environment, I naturally start pursuing higher position because I think that's the right thing to do, because that's what expected of me from my upbringing. I never thought how much that would impact on what truly matters to me, which is my filmmaking and also this community, my YouTube. Last year, I started taking on the position. I started getting busier and busier, and I found myself just week after week going through those craziness and then constantly getting back into burned out. If you look through my videos last year, I was not in a good shape mentally, and I was constantly looking for my creativity. But my brain has been occupied and overwhelmed by my day job, and that caused me having a difficult time to create. If you watch my previous video, you know the importance of creating is to carve out space for your brain to really think and feel And then that's where the creativity come. It took me a long time to realize I kept myself busy is because I can't stand the feeling of productive tension. I can't stand the feeling of not able to do the thing that really needs to get done. And I use I'm busy as an excuse to distract from those negative feelings. And I also made more excuse of I need the money to survive, so I have to take on this job. And it really took me entire year of burnout to finally confronting myself and ask myself this question: is it really worth it not be able to write and create and working on my filmmaking career by getting paid this much of money? And the answer was very obvious: it's not worth it. Making movie and then be able to keep create is the only thing that I feel satisfied and that matters to me. Nothing is really worth it for me to sacrifice my filmmaking career. For some reason, bit by bit, I was getting consumed and eaten by this idea of I need to make more money so I live comfortable. And I feel I start losing myself and I lost my vision. So at the end of last year, I start getting quite depressed and I start reflecting what went wrong. I've been keeping myself so busy with things that doesn't align with my goal. I realized I lost my focus. This is the reality of trying to be a creator, or the reality, let's say, just for the film industry. People always say film industry is very competitive, everybody trying to get in. But is it really competitive because of so many people want to do it? I think the reason it's difficult to get into film industry is not because of the competition, but because of too many people end up giving up on their own. Not because they thought I'm gonna give up, but more of life gets in the way. They need to make money for a living, and all of those things start occupying them and distracting them, move them away from their initial goal. And 5 years, 10 years pass by, people realize, oh, I made a comfortable living and I'm far away from my filmmaking career. It's more about people giving up on their own without even realizing they were giving up. I feel that's what caused a lot of people not be able to achieve in this industry. And I think it's the same for any industry, for anything that people want to achieve. The thing has been holding us back from doing what's really matter is that we can't allow ourselves to face the uncomfortable feeling, the productive tension, the resistance that we have towards the work we really need to do, the thing we really want to do. We start keeping ourselves busy and keep our mind occupied constantly, give us a false sensation that we are busy, we are making some progress, but the fact is those so-called progress that we're making have nothing to do with our goal. One simple example is if you really think about the feeling of scrolling on social media, especially nowadays the short format videos, and you just scroll through 1 minute to next minute to next minute, video after video, do you notice something? After you scroll for an entire hour, you don't really remember what you've seen. You don't remember most of the content or whatever you watched. Not only that, but you have a sense of nagging, burned out feeling afterwards. This is exactly what we have been doing to our mind by keeping ourselves busy, because we keep looking for the next things to occupy our brain. And one thing after another, and then we have a sense of we are occupied by something. But in the end, because of none of those things are truly matters to us and truly align with our goal, we end up not be able to achieve anything. And then when we look back what we have done, we will realize that we've done nothing. Not only it makes you feel empty, but also it makes you feel burned out. And then in the end, you're just going to this downward spiral of feeling more of productive tension and numbing yourself from productive tension by doing more and get more busy. And then you experience more productive tension, and then you get yourself busier and productive tension and busier. It's just back and forth. And this is a downward spiral, and it's going to make you feel extremely burned without really achieving anything. I couldn't wrap this around my head until the last couple months because of how I stepped down from my day job and how I all of a sudden free up this huge amount of time. And all I felt is exhaustion, and I feel guilt of not doing what truly matters to me. And I start journaling and looking for way to recover from that burnt out, and also trying to restore my brain and then focus on what's really matters. During this process, I looking back to last year, it almost felt like I just woke up from a long, tiring dream that I couldn't even believe I was doing so many works last year, and none of them are really goal-driven and focus on what's truly matters to me. The result of that is I wasn't fulfilled, and I was not happy, and I was burned out. So I think what we need to do is to really set a goal and pick the thing that truly matters to us, and making every single decision around that. I want to share a quote with you from Oprah Winfrey that I wrote down many times. It's one of my favorite quotes from her. People get to where they want to go because they know where they want to go. And most people don't know where they want to go. A lot of people are going and being driven by what they think they should do, what other people say they should do, what they carried in their mind for a long time they should do. But the most important question you can ever ask yourself is, what do I really want? Once you can establish for yourself what the answer to that is, and have everything you do, every choice you make, move you in the direction of what you say your vision is. And then when you do that, the force of life rise up to meet you. The reason why most people have such chaotic life is because they are living in chaos in their head. And as soon as you get clear, it clears up. And then this quote basically summarized everything that I want to share with you in this video, and I'm pointing you a direction what to do. Use me as example. Last year, when I getting that promotion, when I want to get paid more, when I want to getting into a higher position at my day job, is the thing I think I should do. And it's also what my family would like me to do, is to get stable in my job, in my financial situation. So those are things in my head what I should do, but they distracted me from things what I really want to do. The answer to that is, how am I finding that balance to really still making some money but prioritize what truly matters to me? So that's why I made that decision of stepping down and get paid less, feeling a little bit unstable financially. All of a sudden, I felt content, and I felt I'm making the exact right decision for myself. I can't speak for you because I don't really know what you've been experiencing, what your financial situation is like, but it's quite important for us to be able to focus on what truly matters to us. And then remember, every single time we're trying to move forward in the things that matter to us, there will be resistance, and we will have a difficult time to accomplish those tasks. And when we're not able to accomplish those tasks, we experience productive tension. And then that's when we have to sit with that productive tension instead of distracting ourselves by doing other things we think is productive. We need to sit there and allow ourselves to get bored. And if you watch my previous videos, you know how important boredom is for creativity. When people are bored enough, they start create. Sitting with yourself and get bored and face the uncomfortable feeling that you feel, face those resistance that you experience. When I'm saying sitting with yourself, I'm literally means sit there, do absolutely nothing. It's not sit there maybe scrolling on videos or social media. And then when you're able to sit through that, you will start wanting to move towards the thing that you really want to do. You will naturally start want to do something about it because that's what your heart really desire to do. You may think, but what about money? I need to make money. I need to pay my bills. I need to make ends meet. So do I. But you can't let that to carry you away and then neglect what really mattered to you for your life. I know it's scary and it feels risky, and I'm still feeling the risk at the moment. But with the great success always come with great risk. To me, I think as long as I can keep a roof over my head and I have enough food to eat, that's enough. For all the rest of my attention, I should dedicate to what truly matters to me. And if you say, I have to do this 9-to-5 job, there's still one thing, a simple thing that you can stop doing, is to stop scrolling on your social media and stop binge TV shows. Because those are the things we do to keep our brain filled with things after things. If we can put our phone down and just sit in front of our desk to do absolutely nothing for long enough, I'm sure you'll start moving towards the direction that your heart desires. Whatever you do, whatever choice you make, to really ask yourself that question, am I doing this to distract myself from the resistance and the productive tension towards what truly matters to me? And then the answer is yes, maybe you should say no to that decision and really start directing everything you do towards what you want. Let's go on this journey of putting our attention towards the things that's matter to us, even if it's uncomfortable, and stop distracting ourselves by occupying our mind with things that doesn't matter. And thank you so much for joining me in this comeback coffee chat. And if you like this video, you might also enjoy the similar topic right here. And be patient, be present, stay creative. I'll see you next week. Bye. Beep.